We're so close. The signal's coming from just beyond this ridge.
Stay on the lookout. You see any movement, run. Sit tight, people. I'm gonna clear the way. It's time for some answers.
Have you noticed? There are carvings all around the city, like on the obelisks. Perhaps they use the energy drawn from the anomaly to power their lights, operate their mills, transport water.
I tried talking to Tiago, but he needs space. I hope he knows that whatever happens, he's one of us. You okay? What's going on, Tiago?
I had a daughter once. Small little critter, about this tall. Having a baby in the trenches, it was stupid. We knew it. She was so frightened of it all, the gunfire, the storms, monsters. Would I tell her stories, pretend it was all just a game? But if we won, we'd win a prize. But she wanted to know what the prize was. I told her there was a place out there, far from all that mud and death. I promised I'd take her there. It was winter when she tried to stop the bleeding. I held her until... It's okay, Papa, she told me. You can still win the prize. I promised her there were no monsters. I promised the same to August. Yet I brought them both into a world full of monsters.
I'm sorry. Friend.
Thank you, Outrider.
What do we have here? Zahidi. I found some more writing from Monroy's people. I think we must be approaching their colony. It seems Monroy didn't believe the Pax were so peaceful. When their tech started getting fried, he suspected the Pax were trying to sabotage him. Then, just as a storm was brewing up, they caught the Pax doing one of their obelisk rituals.
Did Monroy think the Pax were causing the storms?
I thought the same thing when I first saw August in those ruins in the forest.
Monroy ordered his soldiers to stop them. It was on that day that Dr. Indira recorded the first Pax deaths.
Please, collect all the writing you can find for me. Perhaps we can learn their story.
After the first big storms burned out most of their tech, it sounds like Monroy got furious. He demanded explanations from the Pax and access to their powers. They didn't understand. They offered everything they could. They led Monroy through the jungle to their sacred city.
Probably this city. The place we've discovered.
Pax took him to the Grand Temple, tried to show him how they communed with the anomaly. But Monroy thought it was a ploy to assassinate him. He ordered the executions of the Pax leaders and locked down the temple until he could learn how to control it himself.
My God. Monroy, he misunderstood everything the Pax did.
Thank you.
There are countless cages here. They're filled with skeletons. They look like pack skeletons. After they'd executed the pack's leaders, Monroy's people started moving into the city. So this was their colony. They took over the homes of the packs, forcing them to work for them, to serve them.
In other words, they made them slaves. They believed the loss of their machinery was the packs' fault.
Doesn't matter what they believe. There's no excuse for enslaving another race.
There's gotta be hundreds of dead packs here, executed, piled up. This whole city is a mass grave.
Monroy's people, they did this.
I think it's getting real clear who the packs were scared of, who they changed themselves into ferals to protect themselves from.
Seems like they got hit by the worst storm yet. Hundreds died, humans and packs. Some of the obelisks were damaged too, so whatever the packs once were doing to control the storms, they couldn't do it anymore. He feared an uprising, losing control. His packs started to abandon the city. Nikolai Galiatkin. Monroy made him general and put him in charge of weapons production.
No doubt the same weapons the Pharaohs used against them later.
This place, it was a slave market. Monroy, this palace is covered with flags, all with... It's gotta be his face. He made himself king of the Pax.
A king?
A tyrant.
Thank you.
yards clear.
We'll be right back.
Monroy was sending out raids to hunt down the fleeing packs. And that's when the uprising he predicted finally found him. But it wasn't the packs. At least, not as he expected.
The Pharaoh. He never saw them coming.
But Monroy didn't retreat. That asshole dug in, out there in the desert, and tried to track them down, where they were coming from. That's when he found the canyon and the great obelisk. He finally understood there who the Pharaohs were. But that's when he got word that the city was under attack.
And so it was the beginning of the end.
I've made it to the top. Palace is clear.
What do you see?
You better come up here and see for yourself. This Monroy was a madman. Hey, there's a ship! Is that the Caravel?
That's not possible. The Caravel never left. Its engines exploded. Tens of thousands died.
Then what the hell are we looking at? The source of the fucking signal. Monroy's signal. There's no place beyond the storm. It's coming from in there, protected from the anomaly, just like the uplink in your goddamn briefcase.
I don't fucking understand.
Neither do I. It doesn't make any sense. Everyone saw the Caravel explode during its construction. Even if the people left on Earth were able to rebuild the ship, they left after us. We were the first. Nevertheless, what's certain is that Monroy enslaved August's people. He butchered them, and they turned. They mutated into savages willingly, so they could fight back.
I'm done with all this. Whatever's waiting for you on that ship, I want no part of it.
Tiago, you can't leave us now.
I thought you weren't a deserter.
What they did to August's people. What our people did to August, don't you see? Thank you for letting me walk a ways with you.
We're going to finish this. We're finding a way into the Caravel.
This is it now. That ship, the signal, the garden. I'm ready to make some sense of all this. We'll leave on your word, Outrider.